Hi YouTube, this is Dr. Wanda and I'm seated with
Gia
Boo. So we wanted to give you a Tema Newtown update. So what's new? You got your new uniform.
Yeah, I got my new uniform.
She wanted the two-piece uniform. You look cute in it.
Yeah, I wish the skirt was tighter.
Yeah, you lost weight. Before you got it, you got fitted for it, but then by the time you got it,
it was already too big
for me. Well, the seamstress can come back and look out for you.
She's not going to do it. She's not going to do it right away.
Well, okay, so she got a new uniform, two-piece uniform. You got your books. We paid your school fees, which were how much?
200 Ghana CDs.
200 Ghana CDs, which works out to be about $40. So she has her books. That's good. And I actually liked all her books except for the one on French.
I don't know why you don't like French. French is
fine. It's not that I don't like French. It's that I'm very excited about you learning an African language. And I was super duper excited that she was learning Ghana. So they don't have a guy teacher there looking. Her sister mom, Susie, was the guy teacher, but she left the position. So now they're looking, but she don't have anybody to practice French with here. Who are you going to practice French with? It's not the Ivory Coast. There's some African nations that French is the first language. It's not here.
No, I feel like it is here because the way that he's been teaching it.
Do you feel like you're mastering French?
Yeah.
Okay, well then let me shut up.
I mastered French last year.
Let me shut up. Okay, so we have new uniform, you have your books, you're working on French.
Yep.
And what else is happening with you, Tema Newtown girl?
The trouble.
What's the trouble?
There's this girl named Ajoko Gloria, and she's basically my classmate. She's in class 6. She's actually older than me. She's 12 years. Like 11 years. She's older than me, whatever. And we have a big problem.
And that problem is what?
That problem is basically I was at school. We just finished school. We just ended school of the school day. And we get into a car. We take a car. And as soon as we get to station, about to get right out the car, then she just busts out insulting me.
She insults you. And
yes.
You all were having no other conflict before she did that?
No.
So she insults you and she says what?
She said that I'm from the U.S., but I don't have any money. I'm poor, and I can't pay for my own car. And what she's trying to tell me is, I can't get my own taxi on my own without somebody there with me, and that I don't have any money to pay for a taxi without somebody there.
I don't allow Gia to take taxis alone. First of all, she is from the U.S. We don't even do that with our 10-year-olds in America. And furthermore, her taxi is paid for because I send money so that her fees can be covered. So I don't know what she's talking about.
And other is, she not only insulted me, but she was literally trying to beat me up at the station. She was literally punching me.
What prompted this shift in behavior? Because you said she had been your friend prior to that.
Yeah, she was my friend. Then she insulted me. Then I also insulted her back because you always told me if somebody do something to you, always hit it back to the next person. Always hit it back to the person.
Mm-hmm.
So I also...
And you blame that on me?
Yeah.
You're supposed to take up for yourself, yes.
Yes. So I also did it. So then she started beating me. I didn't even hit her. I guess what I said to her, maybe she didn't like it.
You meant... If it's an insult, you meant her not to like it.
Yeah, but she just started...
Took it to another level.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Then she started beating me, punching me, slapping me. Then, I slapped her back and I moved back. Then we got to the road, which is like the walk area. Then I walked into Nana, the one that you helped with her baby with the hat.
Mm-hmm.
I walked into her and I told her, and she said that she should stop what she's doing.
Mm-hmm.
other than that, then the whole entire way she was literally kicking me.
I'm not understanding. Okay. This story has gotten more intense than what you share with me, because what you share with me is like a verbal exchange, and then I guess she tried to get physical, but you kind of rebuked it. What you're telling me now is that this got real physical.
Yes.
So that's why you're upset.
Yes.
Okay, well, Sister Mom, Joseph, these other people, did you inform them? 1 second. Did you inform them that that's what was going on with you?
Yeah.
And how did this...
I informed Joseph first. The first person I ever informed was Joseph.
How did the adults, okay, because you're in the hands of competent adults. How did this get settled?
So it started off with the elders around me. One of the elders, which is your friend, your old friend.
Okay.
The one with the curly hair, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, her. She said that the next time you ever catch her, come and call me, or you beat her.
So she gave you advice to basically defend, alert her, but defend yourself. Okay, yes. The next elder, what happened?
The next elder said, go and tell Susie.
Okay, so the other elder advised you to go to Sister Mom.
And the last elder, he said that I should rather don't tell you. I shouldn't tell you,
mm-hmm.
but I should deal with it by myself.
Well, I mean, there is a space with conflicts with children where children have to stand up for themselves and settle things, and everything can't be managed by an adult. But I also think, I don't like the last suggestion that you're going to tell me, because you and I have a rule. We talk to each other.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing that Gia can't talk to me about. Nothing. And I never want that in place. Whether I agree with her, disagree with her, whether she's right, she's wrong, she knows she can talk to me. So I don't want anybody giving you that advice. I understand that people kind of got upset with you because you came to me.
Yeah, they got upset with me because they thought you were going to call the police, or you was going to get that family in trouble. Mm-hmm. And the school would start getting angry at her.
Mm-hmm.
And everywhere she would go, people would be talking about her, that she beat this American at station, mm-hmm. all kinds of things. They were afraid.
Well,
and they also wanted to seem like they're responsible for me.
That they're doing all the right things to secure.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I understand both ends of that, but I don't care whether she gets in trouble or not gets in trouble. You need to always report first and foremost to your mother. I'm your mother. I'm your guardian. I brought you here. You came through my womb. You don't keep any walls up for me. So one thing I don't agree with here is a lot of times the parents here don't engage deeply with their children.
Yeah.
They don't have that sort of, you know, ability to just talk to their parents about anything. They do talk to them, but not to the degree that G and I have talked. And I was like this way with all of my children. Your best friend is your mama. Don't play these games like you can't talk to me about violence, about sex, about fear, about whatever is going on with you, your own insecurities, your worries. You come to me. I love you. Okay, you come to me and we'll figure it out. So, but then again, like, yeah, you are going to have to figure out how to talk to this girl. I don't like that it got physical because, you know, I'm black. Where we come from, you can talk all you want to, but you don't touch me. You touch me, you got something coming. So that portion, that's the part that I'm not so happy with. That exchanging of rude words, kids kind of do that, the dozens. I don't agree with it. I never was a person that liked it.
She got to a point where she was insulting you.
Yes, I understand that.
She said the most words of all words to say about a parent.
What she said was something to the degree that my vaginal area stunk, and what else? In which I told Gia to tell her, okay, she's welcome to come and wash it. Tell her I come, we can meet up.
And when I told
and she
Susan,
can wash
and
it.
And when I told Susan, Grandma, they just started laughing.
It was like, she can wash it. I told you, I said, that stuff don't bother me. I said, first of all, I don't know the little girl. And then I told her, I said, you know, whatever she says about me is probably the issue with her own parent. She's smelling her mother. She's not smelling me. We don't hang together. So, but Gia was really hurt by it and offended. Isaac explained to us that is a way that engagement happens sometimes. That, you know, privately they say like very, very rude things to each other. Gia's no angel, but in general, that's not her thing. Like, she's never been off into the privately cursing and talking about your mother stuff. So I understand who you are as a human being. But at the end of the day, it's going to get settled. So Gia asked that I come to the school. I'm coming to the school when?
Tuesday.
I'm coming to the school Tuesday. Now, the little girl was scared to even come to school yesterday out of fear that I was coming. And I guess she thought I was going to beat her up. I don't know. I'm not going to have fisticuffs with a kid. But I do want to talk to her about, like, ways that you engage in friendship. I don't like any of the mean girl stuff. I don't like any of the microaggression. And so what that tells me is it's time for a lesson about what it means to like or dislike someone. There's lots of people I don't like, but I don't disturb them and they don't disturb me. And we're okay. They get to be them complete authentic selves and I get to be me. But to go around and talk about somebody, mama, you know, private areas stink and tell somebody they don't have money and then you want to, you know, take it to a fisticuffs, you know, you want to get off on the hidden people, that does have to be managed. Not at the police station, but again among the elders and the guardians that you have. So I'm proud of you that you had enough sense to open up your mouth and admit that this has gotten too big for you, that you're checking out of it, you don't agree with it, and you came to your mother. I don't care how long we live in Ghana. I don't care what elder you meet. I don't care what situation. Who are you to talk to?
You.
All right.
Anything
else as we wrap up? Tim, a new town girl, catching it, going through her own struggles. What else?
The last thing I want to say about her is I've seen her mother. I've seen her mother. Doesn't seem happy about that.
Leave it, Gia.
Not gonna be happy about that.
Most parents aren't. We don't send our kids to school to act a fool.
And especially that you're an American too, so she really.
No, especially because I'm American. It should be because I'm a woman and I'm a mom and I didn't deserve that. How about those apples, okay? All right, so we're wrapping up. Yeah. Anything else you want to say, Tim and Newtown girl? You got Monday off.
Yeah, I got Monday off.
It's a holiday.
Yeah, we wore African wear yesterday.
Did you like it?
Yeah, it got creepy, though,
because
people start wearing makeup and long eyelashes and all kinds.
Yeah. It's nice to not wear our uniform, so.
Yeah.
You all always ask me about Gia, send her wonderful greetings and blessings. I wanted you to have an opportunity to see her yourself. Mm-hmm. So she sat down and told you how her week has been going. Of course, we'll get back to you and let you know how Tuesday turns out, too. Until we meet again.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.